Good. Thank you. Thank you so much. Oh my God, the enemy is a liar. The devil, I saw like the hand beating, beating everything. My God, Father Jesus, look at what he's doing. All right, turn one of them off because the echo is there. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for joining. Thank you for coming. And God is good. Hallelujah. Yes, God is good. God is good. Get angry and give me thousands and thousands of hearts. This is what Silas and Paul, they went through. The enemy was very jealous with them and they wanted to kill them, but they didn't look at that problem. They continue praising God and singing and playing, and they pray. They pray and sing. They pray. Now, the enemy will try to frustrate you, put you in prison, put you in jail, make you chain problems, problem after another, after another, after another. You cannot be free. You can't enjoy. You have been sad. You have been crying. That is why I was talking that you can be crying the night. The night you can be weeping, but the morning, is the joy is coming in the morning. Because the joy is coming in the morning, therefore, the enemy that thought that you will not be happy, they will see you singing and dancing. They will see you rejoicing in the Lord. They will see you different person. They may think that you will never rise up, you will never achieve anything, you will never have anything, you will never have that job. But they will see you with a different job and happy. I think I'm going to prophesy tonight in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. I prophesy to you. When the enemy says no, that's not Jesus. It is not God who said no. It is the enemy. And the enemy has not have the last result. The enemy is the enemy and is defeated. Therefore, I prophesy to you that tomorrow your joy is coming. Tomorrow your job is coming. Tomorrow your marriage is coming. In the morning, you will have children with your own hand. Money is coming to you. You are going to hold money with your two hands. You may need even an accountant to help you. Only if you know how to praise God and thank Him in the midst of trouble. Don't look down your problem. We have seen people who face the problem. Physically, they were beaten seriously, and they were thrown in prison, in jail. But they didn't look at their problem. Instead, they started looking out to praise God and pray. They prayed and praised God. That's what the Bible says. And the earthquake of deliverance fall upon them. I pray that let the earthquake of deliverance fall upon your life and destroy everything that is making you cry. The joy is coming in the morning. I pray that God Almighty will visit you in a special way that you have never seen before. Glory be the name of Jesus. I'm praying for you. I'm praying for somebody. You know who you are. You are chain problems. Chain problems means that you have so many problems. You cannot achieve anything. You don't have a shelter to sleep. You have no place to sleep. But I'm telling you, besides that, in the midst of that problem, start praising God and praying. Don't be sad. Don't pity yourself. Because worry cannot help you. Fear cannot help you. That is the weapon of the devil. Now, God is Almighty God. He sees everything, what is happening to you. So, people of God, forget what is going on. Just start praising God. Just start praising Him and dancing to Him. The earthquake will come and destroy that problem is facing you. The morning is coming. The joy is coming. You shall be happy again. When the enemy said that you will not have that job, you will have that job. When the enemy are turning your children against you, and they say that it is finished, you will never be happy. They have taken all your children. Maybe your children are in prison right now. Maybe your children are sick or they are wandering in the world. And the enemy is happy, looking at this and say, yes, we get ya. They will see your children back. That's what the Bible says. God is going to restore back everything the enemy has taken from you. God Almighty we serve is a faithful God and is a righteous God. That He knows what you are going through. And He will restore back everything that enemy has taken from you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is telling me to tell you there's somebody who has been crying at night, but you pretend it's okay, but nothing is okay. You've been crying privately. The joy of the Lord is coming. The morning is coming. It's all the tears that you have been crying, God is going to wipe them out, and you will be happy again. You've been wondering, what can you do? You have been trying this chain problem. You have been trying this and that, but nothing is showing up. Your joy is coming. Yes, thank you, Jesus. I am praying that God will turn your mourning, will turn your weep to joy. You are overcomers. You are overcomers. The Lord will turn your circumstances around you to favor you. No curses shall land on your head, for it is written, no one can curse whom the Lord has blessed. I am declaring every curse in your life, that every curse that has been issued against you, it will not prosper because God has blessed you. All those curses, I break them. I break them to pieces. I pray that let the angelic of God fall upon you, that earthquake, and break every curse in your life in the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Thank you, my friend. That the curse that has been working against you, they have been placed a curse for not you, not even your parents, your forefathers. They say curse has been placed there. That curse has been affecting you, affecting your family, affecting you so much. All your brothers and your siblings, your brothers and sisters, no one is doing well. Everywhere, wherever they are all over the world, but no one is doing well because of the curse that has been placed in your family. Therefore, I take authority by the power and the blood of Jesus. I break them in pieces. I am asking the earthquake of God to go and destroy that curses in the name of Jesus. You shall be celebrated again. Yes, in the name of Jesus. That curses has been broken into pieces in Jesus' name. The pattern, the chain problem. Please. Prayer line, turn off one of your devices. If you are watching the iPad and the cell phone, you have to turn one because the echo is coming. Prayer line is very sensitive than Periscope. So make sure that you turn one off because the echo is going to affect the video. I thank God, and God is God. I am praying that everything that the enemy has said to you, that is a lie, is a lie. It is not going to function. It is not going to succeed. Invisible chains of slavery, tying you down, I am destroying them. You know there is this invisible chains of slavery. You work very hard. You try everything, but that invisible chain that you have been, they have chained you, it cannot allow you to be happy, to enjoy. You work like a slave. You, because you are having invisible chain, therefore I cut that chain into pieces in the name of Jesus. That chain problem, they are marked you, that every problem, they are coming upon problem, I am commanding them to catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Yes, I am praying that every evil agreement against your life, I command them be scattered. Every evil agreement, maybe they came while you are sleeping and they make agreement with you. A person was telling me, a man from Africa was telling me that somebody came to while he was sleeping, and they forced him to sign the document. After signing the document, he was forced to sign the document. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So the man signed the document unconsciously while he was sleeping. And when he woke up, he felt so bad. If he was feeling bad, he felt bad. He was very angry that he signed a document without it, because he was forced in the dream. That which means that he made agreement with the devil unconscious while he was sleeping. The devil did not go physical or when he was not sleeping. He went there when he was sleeping and they forced him to sign the document. So I told the man, cancel it and destroy it in the name of Jesus. That one is agreement. The enemy is making you unconscious. Therefore, many people, they are having problem like that. The dreams that make you to do things that you are not supposed to do, let that dream be destroyed and break into pieces in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, I pray that God would help you and deliver you in Jesus' name. I pray that God would deliver every one of you that is going through this problem, chain problem. They shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I am praying that God will deliver you in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. I have to stop here, and I'm praying for prayer line. People, don't go away. I want to pray for you. If you have any needs that you need me to pray for you, I'm going to pray for you. And tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock, we will be on our service, Sunday service, and then we'll finish our prayer and fasting. Tomorrow, after the service, you are free to eat. We will be finishing our prayer and fasting. And I want you to invite your friends to come Sunday service tomorrow, 8 o'clock. If you have a church to go after this, then you can go. But you have to come because I have a special message that I want to deliver for you. The last one for our prayer and fasting. God bless you so much. And let's join prayer conference. I'm going to pray for an individual. If you have any prayer request you want me to pray, you can just tell me and I will pray for you. And when I prophesy something to you, write it down. It is yours. You don't have to ask me, what did I say? You keep it and watch it. It will come to pass. If you want me to, when you remind me what it is, then I can remember to explain to you. Because when I am in the realm of the spirit, I don't know what I say. I say so many stuff and you are not the only one. There are many people that need prophecy or need prayer. So if I've prayed for you and I say something, you can record it or you can write it down. I could advise people to record their prophecy so that you can follow it. God bless you so much. Go to our website, www.overcomers.dhministry.blogspot.ca, or you can send us email, overcomers@gmail.com. We have the number, you can reach us, and you can go to our website. All the contact is there. You don't have to worry about the number. If you visit the website, all the information is there. I want the people to start visiting the website. That is where the prayer points are and other information that are there. It can help you. All the videos are there. When you look at the website, you may see YouTube, Google Plus, Twitters. All those are it's for you to get to share it to your friends. Share these videos to your Facebook. Share them. share them. I thank people are sharing their Twitter. I've seen so many people sharing Twitter now, the videos. It is there. It could help people. People, they have no idea. They don't know what is going on with them. But through these videos, it can deliver them. Some churches, they have no idea about the deliverance. I was like that. I was in the church. I was a minister. I was doing everything, but I didn't know this deliverance until God himself, through his mercy, he is the one who introduced me this deliverance. And in fact, even those days, I don't think whether I could take it, I could believe it. A man came to our prayer yesterday. When he saw the prayer we were doing, he ran away. He could not stand because he said, what kind of this prayer? These people, they have no mercy. This is witchcraft prayer. He ran away. So even me those days, I could do the same. But God, who is God, who introduced me these prayers, I thank him so much. So if you send it to your friends, share with them. Tell them that every prayer we are doing, it's from the Bible. And it is there. You can see it. It is written there very clearly. It is not witchcraft. I'm not a witch. So all the prayers is best from the scriptures. Except we use it live. We command it. We use it live. Yeah? We use it like the way we talk. That's how we make the prayer points. Or prayer machine and prayer bullets. You can make the prayers through the scriptures. When you see the scriptures, you read it and you make the prayer through that. So this prayers is not witchcraft like the way people say. There's a scripture which confuses people, and people they are holding on one part only. I have been telling you all the time, the enemies who knows what he's doing is a bad enemy. The enemy who does not know what he's doing is a good enemy because he doesn't know, and God can forgive him. But an enemy who knows, a witch who is preparing you, doesn't want to sleep, who wants to see you dead, wants to see your children dead, wants to see you lose your job, he is there. He is worshiping idols. He's talking to the sun the whole night, the moon the whole night, talking the star the whole night about you. Then you say that is a good enemy. That's not a good enemy. God, the Bible says, let enemies of God scatter and let God arise. So there's enemies of God and there's your enemies. And there's an enemy who does not know what they are doing. There's enemies who does not know what they are doing. That's a good enemy. But the enemies who stayed at night chanting and speaking against you is a bad enemy. You have to fire back what they are doing to you. That's why you pray the sickness, like cancer, like sickness you are having now, the pain you are having. These pains, they belong to the owner. The owner of the pain is there. Why can't you release that pain back to the owner to feel it? If the pain, the sickness, the owner, he's putting on you, and you take that sickness and you put to him so that he can feel it. Because he doesn't feel it, that's why that sickness is still with you. If he take it and give it to the owner, then the owner will feel it. That's what they don't want. When we pray back to the sender, we return back to the sender. You will every sickness, even poverty, you command you poverty, hear the word of God, I'm returning you back to the sender. Back to the sender. Jesus died for me to be rich, not to be poor. So you command the that demons like hey, go back. Yes? You say that Jesus himself died for me to be rich, not to be poor. So I command you poverty in my life to go back to the sender. Yes. Sickness, hear the word of God. Anything that you are high blood pressure, it is not from God, it's from the devil. So the devil is the owner of that high blood pressure. Ask that blood pressure, go back to the sender. Anything that you are suffering, anything that you are facing, call that the thing, the name, and tell the thing, go back to the sender. You don't belong to me. I'm not your owner. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Yes, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, right now, as I commit your people into your hand, God, every trouble, every problem they are facing, I command them to return and go back to the sender in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I praise you and I give you the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much, Periscope. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. Love you. Love you. Call me. My number, if you didn't get the number, maybe you want to know what's the number. The number is 647-608-5207. That is the cell phone number. You can text me. You can send your text message. You can call me on WhatsApp or Skype. So use that number, 647-608-5207. Thank you very much. God bless you. Bye bye. Bye. Thank you. Bye. Bye.